Coming, coming, coming.
If you're going to San Francisco, Scott McKenzie.
Oh yeah, people! Live! Where's it from?
If you're going to San Francisco, be sure to wear some flowers in your hair. If you're going to San Francisco, you're gonna meet some gentle people. All across the nation, such a strange vibration. People in motion. There's a whole generation with the agaves impatient.
Yes, come. Come to San Francisco. You're gonna find I got my pinas blind. Triple shave. Oh, you will come to San Francisco. 'Cause this fall in Monterey will be an expo there. Yeah, did you like that? Oh, key change. If you're going, folks, I'm hearing pinas calling me. Now they're down and out in the fields, and they're talking to me. Lip, it's a special show. What rustled you and wrested you out of your sleepy haze, your agave funk, your pineal parabo? Huh? What could that be? Well, something is happening, friends, and it's happening right in my backyard. It's special enough that I wanted to alert everybody to it. So, welcome to another super special edition of the Tequila Whisperer Show. I'll get to the chat. I see it's running over there, and I'll just hold on. I want to tell you, first of all, how good it feels to be back in this comfortable place where we're all together, and it just does feel really good, you know? It makes me want to, like, pour something right away. Can we please get to it? For musical selections tonight for our special Monterey Expo, the Monterey Tequila and Mezcal Expo, which is coming October 6th. That's like a week from tomorrow, Saturday, people. To Matterday. Yes, Monterey, I'll be there. I'm going to be walking around. I'm going to be walking around drinking. I'm going to be walking around singing. I'm going to be walking around sipping. And I want you to come. I want you to get a ticket. I want you to come to Monterey Tequila Expo. And I want you to expose yourself. Not to me. I want you to expose yourself to gourmet tequilas. Northern California's biggest tequila expo. It's happening. So, That's what's happening tonight. I'm going to be talking about Monterey. We're going to be listening to the classic Monterey Pop Festival. Happened exactly 45 years ago this year. It was in the summer of 67. It was an amazing amalgam of talent. All the acts worked for free. Don't know if you know that. They all donated their time and their fees to charity. And it was not only the first kind of major pop festival, but it also was this beautiful melding of LA and San Francisco. So that's why you've got like groups, you know, they would have big festivals like this for a couple of years later, but not quite as centered as like LA, Mamas and Papas, help me out here. Hold on, let me cheat here, because there were some New York contingents. You know, of course, the airplane is from San Francisco. And well, then they got the Who. So it's mostly I'm completely blowing what I just said. But the thing is, the nexus of the Root was in L.A. with Lou Adler and Papa John Phillips from the Mamas and the Papas. And then you had Bill Graham from San Francisco, and they were melding and bringing acts, and the Beatles were involved. You know, where did I get my information from, wacko as it may seem, is this really cool definitive book that just came out within the last year called A Perfect Haze by Ken and Harvey Kubernick. Kudos. It's an amazing book that tells the entire history of the festival. And it just goes day by day. It was a 3-day festival. It's loaded with pictures. And check this out. Including, oh, here's something you may recognize from my Facebook page. Does that sound look familiar? Yeah, hello, little Janice. But where's the lip? The lip walking around. So, you know, this thing is just, you know, look, Mr. Moon. And, you know, Jackie and the Barbados with Jimi Hendrix. And, you know, Jerry, see, and we end on Jerry. So check out this book, A Perfect Haze. It's really beautiful. All right. Yeah. Ravi Shankar. Okay, I see everybody's into the Monterey Pop Festival. So what we're going to do tonight is we're going to taste some medal winners from last year's Monterey Pop. I was about to say Monterey Pop Festival. We're going to taste some last year's winners, and then I'm going to give you my take on how I think they fare, you know? So the first one we're going to taste is we're going to start with a Blanco. And let me put some music on here, and we'll talk about it. Okay. All right, check this out while I go get that bottle. I got to go upstairs. I got to go in the back 40 and get that bottle.
Boy, hasn't this been something? Something we can really be proud of, everybody. It's been so groovy. Yesterday we were walking along, just looking at the booths and jewelry and things, and everything was so quiet and peaceful, such good vibrations.
Good vibrations!
And everybody who thought this thing was going to go off badly uptight, and let's thank God for that.
It's time. It's a welcome back show. So you wanna be a rock and roll star?
Listen now,
hear what I say.
Just get an electric guitar and take some time to learn how to play.
Okay, yeah, you have correctly identified that as the Birds doing a lightning-fast version of So You Want to Be a Rock and Roll Star. Okay, let me check out the chat. Am I missing anything? I'm seeing a lot of fun people. I see that some people are very big on the Monterey Pop Festival, like CTSG knows everybody who's been there and who didn't show up. And wow. Kelly, I had no idea about you, darling, but I'm glad to know it. Very glad to know it. I see we got a ton of guests in the house. So I'm going to tell you just one more time, because it'll help your experience. If you're into it, sign up for a Ustream account, and you'll be able to chat along with us, okay? And you won't just have to watch this. I know it takes a kind of takes a little bit to get in there for Ustream, but do it. It's worth it. So I'm just looking at Johnny Effin Boots showed up. Don Nam. Ah, Azul Imperial. Well, we're about to get to you, buddy boy. Yes. Pina 77. We're all back in the house. Feeling good. Mr. Witch was here. Right on. All right, so I got to scroll down here to see what the bottom of the chat looks like. All right. Effin Boots. Cookers here. All right. So let's get right to the first brand for tonight, shall we? So we're going to be tasting a Blanco. Forgive me if I got to do some reading. Oh, somebody was talking about Hugh Masekela earlier. So you check out Hugh Masekela in the background. So here we've got Azul Imperial, a Blanco from, and now forgive me, now this is, if I'm not mistaken, this is Highlands Tequila. And, excuse me, correct me if I'm wrong on that, because I didn't get quite an answer for that in the questionnaire that I sent out to you, Marco, if that's you. But I'm tasting some mustiness and muskiness, and it's really working for me. And I believe that what we're looking at here is a Highlands Blanco. It's approximately $23 in the retail world, so it's also something that's completely completely affordable. It's horno baked, but then it's a stainless steel distillation, and it's ground in a Molino. It's certainly not Tohono ground. All right, does everybody know about that? Any questions about Azul Imperial? Do I need to show it? Pancho showed up. How is it, Lip? Well, hold on, god damn it, I'm getting to that. All right. Oh, so, okay, I see there's a couple people who are, I see some people are coming to Monterey. This is great. Now remember, you're going to taste all these brands at Monterey on October 6th, Saturday at 6, I believe it's 6 o'clock. Callie, help me out on that one. It's either 6 or 6:30. You know, come by at 6 and get a good place in line, because the Lip's going to be drinking all the good stuff, which is kind of all the stuff. All right, anyway, so let's check out this Blanco. Let me take a couple of sniffs and check out Hugh Masekela. Okay, so one of the reasons I picked the Blanco from Azul Imperial is it's got this really nice, as I said, it's kind of a mustiness. It's got a little bit of acidity. This is all on the nose, but it's giving you a nice round bottom feel. That kind of thing where, you know, after you're sipping a little bit, you want to just go back and sniff it, and it takes you back up. It's not overly crisp. It's not overly bright. And sometimes those are flavors that don't quite appeal to me. It doesn't have any kind of extra spice, cinnamon, or something like that going on. All right. So let me check this out. And the MGs. Hey, I spared no expense. What are you drinking? seeing what you're drinking in the chat. Looking good. Tequila is drinking Corito. What age is that Corito? I'm a big fan of the Blanco. Casino Playanejo, right on. See it in age, you bootstrap. So let me tell you what's going on with this Blanco. A lot of things are happening here. So I'm getting a really beautiful mouth coverage. It's not exactly a chewy tequila, but there's also no glycerin feel. It's not thin, doesn't feel watery. I'm getting some alcohol, you know? I'm feeling that, but the finish is delightful. This Blanco is really speaking to me. It's giving me loads of agave flavor. I mean, this is the I wanted to tell you the gnome. This is the same gnome from Ixá, which is kind of a new super organic brand. I believe that they are working on their certification at Azul Imperial. They're working on their organic certification because I believe that's an organic distillery. And I'm feeling, you know, that kind of naturalness. I know, don't laugh at me, goddammit. $15.49 is this gnome, so check it out and see what else they make. But you know, this is a $23 bottle of Blanco. It's good. So, you know, for $23, you're going to be going back to this a lot. It's a good sipper. It's going to be a great mixer. Although, it really depends on what you're mixing because it's got a wonderful high must to it. And, you know, some ages are better mixed in different cocktails. You know, sometimes I like a repo for a certain kind of cocktail. So I want you to, you know, taste this very closely at Monterey. Find me as I walk around with my party caballito. Okay? What are you guys saying? Anything over here I need to know? If you don't know who this is,
one pill makes you small, and the ones that mother gives you don't do anything at all. Go ask Alice, when she's 10 feet tall. And if you go chasing rabbits, and you know you're going to fall. Smoking caterpillar has given you the call. The call, Alice, when she was just small. When men on the chessboard get up and tell you where to go.
Hey, I'm singing with grace, my fantasy. Let me go see if I have any sun tosti. All right. Check out the airplane. I'll be right back. You didn't think I could hit that high note, did you? I decided to go up there. I decided not to do the harmony, the off-harmon harmony. Let's go feed your head! Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now, you know, I'm checking out this Santosti because I wanted to start cleaning my palate for the repo that we're going to be getting into. But I got to tell you, I am still getting a finish from this Blanco. Azul Imperial. Nice going. Where did you come from? It's amazing. Really. It's good stuff. It's exciting stuff. Look at me. I'm smelling my water. Hold on. All right. Anything happening in the chat I need to know about? Let me get myself going here. All right. Lippy, open the Tapatio bottle I just gave you. Why would I do that? I'm going to be trading that tomorrow. No, I'm kidding. Of course I'm going to open that bottle. All right. Now. Lippy, you know what I need is like I need a chat stoplight, like whip, whip, like when somebody's yelling, you need to hit the yell button, you know, and then it goes, Lippy, whatever. No, come on. All right, here we go. Hey, I got a show to do here. I can't be chatting in the chat. Chattanooga, the Chattanooga chat, chuka. All right, let's get to the repo. Important. Now, are the Mi Casa people, I see we still have some guests. Is there anyone from Mi Casa in the house? This is Arturo and his family. So I picked Reposado as one of my favorite ages of Mi Casa. I got to tell you, I'm a big fan of Mi Casa's Añejo too. It's good stuff. Mi Casa, are they around? I'm just looking. Art. Yeah, is Art around? Well, anyway, he might be here. He might be guesting because he was telling me that he didn't have a Ustream account yet. So I want to tell you about Mi Casa, which is a wonderful new brand from a very committed family team. Yeah, baby! Why don't you just pour yourself what you want, you Billy? Yeah. Okay, so Mi Casa is made at Gnome $14.99. Now, $14.99 has been around, you know, they've made a lot of contract brands, but I want to tell you something. I find that this brand coming out of $14.99 is one of the best way to describe it is rich. It's rich feeling. It doesn't veer very far from a basic $14.99 flavor profile, which is like the Blanco has a lot of kind of cinnamon spice, very high sweet, kind of a thin feel, but not manipulated. There's still some bottom end to it. There's a balance. And that's what I'm liking about this Mi Casa. It's a balanced Reposado. I'm going to sniff it and give you my impressions. And I remember the taste feeling, again, very rich and balanced. Where was I going to go with that? Call in the stunt lip, quick. look, I'm gonna play a little music and think about my place in the universe. Right? I'm getting like a little bit of cinnamon toast, which is makes sense because it's coming from a cinnamon infused, well, not infused, but you know, it's on the cinnamon scale of flavor. And remember, these are kind of under the radar brands. They're not super expensive and gourmet, so don't expect them to be on that caliber. They're not, but for what they are, really good stuff. All right, so let me give this a sip.
Electric.
lip is slipping. So yeah, I believe Arthur Arturo, I believe he created that label himself, Zen Runner. It's really interesting. Pretty photographed and cool. The chimes of freedom flashing. All starry-eyed and laughing, as I recall when we were caught, kept on no track of ours, for they hang suspended. That's drawn? Really? Are you shooting me? As we listen, you drew that? Time, and we watch with one last look, spellbound and swallowed. Come on, man, you didn't draw... Wait a minute. So you drew the front, but you didn't draw these agave fields. Or the tree in the back, right? For the countless countries that keep missing, strung out once and were. Those are my dad's, and this one is ours. Oh, okay, excellent. Eli, you're here. Okay, but those are pics on the side. No, it's beautiful. It's a beautiful drawing. It's great. It's a family affair. Great. This is what we love, people. This is, well, I'm just going to call you Eli because everybody will know you in the chat that way. This is Eli's, so that I don't have to scream over my music. So this is Eli's family, this is his family agave fields. Let me, just look through here and see if I can find a little more information for you. So this is about a $40 to $45 Blanco, Reposado. Let's be very clear. I'm drinking the Repo. I have tried the Blanco and the Añejo. This is aged about 10 months in American oak, you know, white oak from, says it's from Heaven Hills Distillery in Kentucky. Lightly char on the casks. And they're thinking about an XA that will be coming out, at some point. Oh, here's something that's really cool. I don't know if Eli said this in the chat. This is very cool. It's a middle name. This is very cool. These agaves were grown in Michoacán. So these aren't even Jaliscan, or normally we'll see that, or Guanajuatan, is that right? Or something like that. Or where is the lip is completely slipping. Ha! I sound like Tweety. Where is baby? Are you watching this? Ha! Where is Coralejo made? That's not Guanajuato. That's because that's where Herman's from. Where was that? Yeah, Michoacán. This is so cool. So, what do you do? What do you truck the agaves down to the Highland Distillery? Amazing. I'm telling you, you know, I can taste the difference. There's stuff that happens. There's stuff that happens in the distillery that gives it a kind of a distillery feel to it, and a certain taste. But there is a richness, and I wonder if it has to do with where these agaves, yeah. Okay. So he's saying, yes, it's about 60, 70 miles north. So here's what's happening. As you sip and you take a kind of I'd call this a Michelle Obama, because she's rising. Her star is rising. Again, it's a light reposado with a lot of spicy bottom end. It's not extra complicated. It does not have any kind of vegetal, umami, mushroom, any of that stuff that I like. It's not on that scale of flavor, or, you know, it's not on those flavor profiles. It's on the more spicy cinnamon. There's a lot of oak in there, but it's really nicely balanced. There's a really wonderful place. So Eli, do you guys have your own master distiller? Were you the one who told me that it was a woman? I'm sorry. Hold on. Let me just check this out. I might be wrong. Yes. You said the master distiller is a woman. which is amazing. I had not known that about 1499. I don't know if she is 1499's master distilleress, mistress distiller, but I'm going to tell you, you've done a really wonderful job. There's a nice balance here. Again, when you know, I'm tasting these. The beauty of Monterey is that you're getting to taste lots of brands like this that are, again, under the radar, a little unsung. And, you know, Eli, can we make a deal? I want you to give everybody a nice pour at Monterey. And as a matter of fact, I want Azul Imperial to give everybody a nice pour. As a matter of fact, I want the other two brands we're about to taste to give everybody a nice pour. I know you can keep coming back, but there's just something about, could you, you know, double what you think you're going to put in there? But there's not going to be like 5,000 people. You know, there might be 4,000. I think it's going to be pretty excited. It's going to be pretty popular. But, you know, you're going to want to taste this, sip it around. You're going to want to take another taste, and you're going to want to walk around with it. I think this is a table you're going to want to come back to. So, all right, that's as much as I'm going to say for now. Nice going on this repo. And really, I want everybody to think about Mi Casa Añejo, because where you started going with the Añejo, really, you know, I've said this before, what I like about a great reposado is it's got its own personality. It doesn't feel like it was stopped arbitrarily in the middle of the age cycle just to make a repo. Okay, now we got a repo. You guys have stopped this at a really good place. And the Añejo, while it refers back to this, it's not just this with about two more months of aging. As a matter of fact, let me just tell you, I believe, help me out here. Yeah, the Añejo is 30 months in white oak. So that Añejo is quite aged. And yet, again, I think owing to your mistress distiller, it's not a huge heavy plank of oak. You know, it's not over oaked is where I want to go. And for these prices, you're doing God's work. Yeah. Oh, what will Bill Maher say to me tomorrow? Say, Lip, how dare you mention. All right. Anything in the chat before I put some music on and we go to the Añejo? All right, a lot of people, I want you to get your ample asses up to Monterey. Listen, it's Monterey. Oh, my God. It's gorgeous. It's on the water. It's, you know, there's mountains, and then you come down to the water. It's beautiful, dramatic ocean. I want you to come early. I want you to come early and spend a lot of money. You know, go come to town and eat some great food. Friday night, there's a dinner. Don't know. That might be the VIP dinner. But, you know, there's going to be all, it's going to be filled with tequila people all weekend. You're going to want to come. You know, if you're on the fence, I want this show to take you over the fence. Just to come up and see me. What a crazy thought. That's not what I really mean to say. But you will have a great time. Some really good brands. Go to the Monterey website, which is, I don't even know what it is here. It's like MontereyTequilaExpo.com. You know, look it up. Do I have to do everything for you, Jesus Christ? That's my second God reference in about 2 minutes. Something's happening. The Lip found religion in the couple of months I was off. I think I found religion. All right. Everything good here? Anything in the chat? Anybody screaming at me? Lip. Oh, yeah, there's also going to be a discount tickets. Whoa, what did he just say? Yes, I am authorized to discount some tickets. So watch my Facebook page, which is facebook.com/tequilawhisperer. I'm going to be offering a certain percentage off. Forgive me if I don't say what it is because I don't think it's been finalized, but it's going to be substantial. So that's happening like really fast. In fact, I think, you know, Crystal and Omar are like watching this right now. In fact, Crystal, if you're watching, put it in the chat if you've decided, but it's going to be substantial. So you're going to even want to come, you're going to want to come even more. Yes, you want to arrive. Oh, I bought my ticket. Uh-oh. Don't worry, Tequila Bob. I'm going to pour extra for you, okay? Whatever. Okay, here we go. You got me discounted. Jay Bremen. Jay Abramaman, mom. All right, anyway, look, I'm going to play some music. Can we please get to this Añejo now? Aren't you dying to know what's coming up with the Añejo? Of course you are. All right, what's up here? Oh. Okay, everybody. Let me give this an intro here. Everybody at the Monterey Festival wanted to see this next act. I mean, they really wanted to see it. This performer brought the house to its knees, and it's not who you think it is. I don't think, but this made this performer's name and blew them out to the stellar stratosphere. And I was so young at the time, this person didn't get a whole lot of love until much later. So I bring to you, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? The great, the late, who called it? Otis Redding.
We'd like for you to kind of, we're going to slow it down this time and sing a soulful number. This song.
This is Tequila, is that, Alderete.
You know, we all ought to sing sometime.
Yeah. This is
the love crowd, right? We all love each other, don't we?
We all love our tequila, don't we?
Let me hear you say yeah! All right.
Otis, he loves us!
I've been loving you too long to stop now. As you become a habit to me, I've been loving you, oh, too long, and I don't want to stop now. Can you do that one more time? Just like, do it just one more time, one more. I can't stop now. You were kind, and your love is growing cold. My love is growing stronger as I fare.
I've been loving you,
oh, too long, and I don't want to stop now. No,
I hear you, Tasty, but the vault is closed.
I've been loving you just a
I gotta tell you, he was a lot more than sitting on the dock of the bay, you know? This guy was an amazing performer for the video that I've seen of him, and of course, hearing him sing, but what a tragedy. But we have what we have. We have the recordings we have. So, I saw Don Nam talking about our next brand right up here. So this is Tequila Alderete. Check it out! Is Ronnie Alderete in the house? So say yo yo, Ronnie. You know, Alderete, these people are like Monterey born and bred. Not only is Ronnie and his family gonna be at the expo, but they're leading a tour out into their artichoke farm. Jeez! Let's get that artichoke going on. Yeah, so what's going on here? Artichokes and tequila, baby. All right, so I don't know if Ronnie made it. You'll be able to see him at the expo. So let me tell you a little bit about, check out the color of this blonde, of this añejo. It's quite dark. Can you see that? Poet and one man man. Who knew that Simon and Garfunkel were at Monterey Pop? I didn't know, but now I know. It's really true. All right. It looks like T1 Añejo. Well, I guess a lot of Añejos are that color. We could fill in that blank with a lot, but fair enough. I'm willing to go there. Let me tell you a little about Tequila Alderete. Hold on. So, what you're dealing with, now you've got something that's been aged for 27 months in American oak. These are in Jack Daniel's barrels, proprietary yeast. Right now, it's only in California, just came out. Small family operation, like so many of the brands that are going to be in Monterey. They this is why I like this brand. Made, baked in a horno, you know, in the traditional steam clay ovens, copper distilled. But I'm going to tell you something. This añejo, for me, jumped way over all of the other ages of Alderete. The other ages are completely worthy, especially for their price point, which is not bad. It's not exactly the bargain basement. For instance, this is a $60 añejo. But I want to tell you, it starts out with like a very acidic flavor profile. It's got an acidity like, I used to call it like a ketchup pack. Kind of a vinegary acidity, very bright Blanco, very sprangly, very sharp. And what happens is, when you get to the Añejo, using that Blanco as a seed stock, you really come up with something singular. And I pre-tasted this about a week and a half ago, and I was like posting on Facebook as I want to do, like, oh, I'm just testing out. And after about three or four sips of this Añejo and coming back and smelling, this has every kind of classic Añejo. It's got a very heavy hand. Now, I want to qualify that, because when I say that, it's not a bad thing. But and Don Nam, you just said that you tasted this. So I'm happy to have you, you know, in the chat here. Tell me your feelings about your tasting notes on this Añejo. It's got a thick, heavy hand. It's got like a slather of oak and spice and wood and vanilla, but doesn't feel manipulated. Feels very natural. I'd put it in the company. It starts to get where like Cuervo Añejo, you know, that treasure bottle. Now, it doesn't taste like Cuervo Añejo, and I'm not comparing them. But when you taste Cuervo Añejo, that is not a light Añejo. Centinela is a light Añejo. Ocho is a super light Añejo. This is a thick, juicy slab that you just want to bite into, right? What, Don Nam? Oh, he missed something. Well, Don Nam, I'm just talking about your tasting notes. So what I'm talking about here is a really super aged, I showed you the color. So let me take a sip here, and you guys enjoy I'm gonna shoot ahead here a little bit to give you something. Well, I feel like, yeah, I want to give you one of my favorite acts from Monterey. Are you ready for the mighty Steve Miller? Exciting! It's good stuff!
Have my money tell you what I do. I go downtown and buy a
I'm looking for this killer picture of Steve Miller.
Hey, no mama knows you look so fine. Cruising round in that a Mercury 49. I'm gonna buy you a Mercury. Cruise you up and down the road.
I mean, it's so cool. It's worth it. Frame that picture. It's beautiful. I'm really getting into it. I'm gonna do a whole Steve Miller show coming up. I'm gonna get Steve Miller down here. We're gonna sing together and drink a lot of tequila.
Hey, mama, to choose you, what I do.
Okay, so buy a Mercury or two, I'd buy Alderete. Alderete or two. One for me, two for you. Excuse me. Okay, so I just have to. I just had to kind of bring it down here for a second and really get into this añejo. All right. How's everybody feeling out there? Everybody feeling good? You drinking things? You loving things? Yeah. Yeah. Hey, let me tell you a little bit about Alderete. So I told you everything about it. I'm realizing I already told you this. So it says that their agaves come from Aranda. So this is a Highlands tequila. And I'm going to tell you, you know, this is one of those tequilas that, you know, you could drink a lot of this stuff. Did Don Nam ever come back and say, like, what he thought about things? Not going to press you too much, Don Nam, but you know, you should be drinking more of this, dude. yeah, I see what you're saying in the chat about me. We will be visiting Alderete this year on the Blue Agave Tour. It's good. There's some good stuff here. And you're really going to want to check out this añejo. Monterey Tequila Expo. Right? Are you with me, people? You're going to want to sidle up to that. I know I haven't described the taste yet. Because, honestly, it's one of those añejos where you go like, it's very well balanced. It's hard to pull out flavor profiles. It's got a beautiful sweetness. The agave comes through. The best part about it is the balance. It really is nicely balanced. Again, it's not a life changer. But for the price, you probably get this for around $50. For the price, it's a great sipper. This is not a mixer. This is something that rewards continued sipping. As a matter of fact, you know, I'm going to be asking Alderete to, you know, back the truck up to the man cave, because I would like to have a lot of this on hand, and I'd like to be taking this to parties. Now, I'm getting a finish here. I didn't get a whole lot of finish on the Mi Casa Repo, and remember, I got a really big finish on the Azul Imperial Blanco. But this this Alderete Añejo, it's giving me a nice, warm, sweet bath. I highly recommend it. Go to the booth, you know, stock up on this stuff, because you can trust the lip on this one. You're going to get excited about this Añejo. Now, I think we better switch some gears here, dude. You know, think about things. I want you all to get to the core of the Monterey Pop Festival, 1967. Yeah, June, 1967. Who were the reigning kings and queens of that pop festival and of the California sound in general? Question mark, upside down, question mark. Who would that be? Oh, maybe that would be, ladies and gentlemen, the mamas and the papas. Yeah.
We'd like to sing a song that was based upon this very great land in which we are now sitting and squatting upon.
All the tequila's gone, and the agave has gone away. I'm trying to pour, but I get in my own way. But I will tell you today, there's a lot of other stuff in this brand that's coming your way. Thank you. Thank you, Monterey.
You can have this every year, you know. You all can stay if you want.
Oh, that was Mama Cass. There's no mistaking that voice. I wish you could stay, Mama. Cass Elliott, ladies and gentlemen. Do a whole show with Cass Elliott. We're going to all eat ham sandwiches, which I believe is an urban myth. I believe she didn't choke on a ham sandwich. Weight notwithstanding. So anybody want to clear that up for us before we move on? So I saw you saw me pour the saw. So this is Don Elias. All the Don Elias is gone to my... Now this is what I'd call an Obama pour. Yeah, that's what I'd call it. This is a very dark. It's extra aged. So let's get the fact sheet on Don Elias. Or Don Elias, shall we? All right. Yeah, see, that's because she's fat, they said that. I agree. That is completely messed up, man. And, you know, see, in all seriousness, Cass Elliott deserves a whole lot better than that. But I'm not here to defend her. I never knew her, but boy, do I love her sound. She's got one of those voices, like, completely distinct. And found it immediately and stayed there. It's great. Okay. Don Elias. Hello, my friend. So, the extra añejo. Is Don Elias in the house? Because actually I don't have the fact sheet on how many months the XA was aged, but I do know that it was baked in a horno. Ground traditionally in the Molino, and it's a stainless distillation. Yeah, I don't know if Don Elias is in the house, maybe, but anyway, so these are lowland agaves. This is not a Highland brand, Don Elias. This bottle is somewhere around $70 for the XA, and their Blanco starts around $35, so it just goes right up the line. So why did I choose Don Elias as the extra añejo? Well, you know, there's a sweetness to this brand, and it starts out in the Blanco, and you can taste it all the way through. And that is just a fact of my opinionated palate. So that is not my favorite flavor component. What happens as Don Elias, as they age their tequilas, that sweetness starts to mingle and co-mingle with other flavors. By the time you get to the XA, you've got something completely on the other hand. So what I want to do is give this a sniff, give it a sip, and start giving you my feel on this XA. Which you can taste, of course. Where? What did he say? At the who knows where? You got it, Chiefy. Monterey Tequila Festival, October 6th.
I'd like to introduce a perfect example of what the world's coming to. It's Jefferson Airplanes in France.
Somebody.
just speed it up. I agree, Larry. They're all hyped up in 1967. Thank you. Who called that? That was Jefferson Airplane. That was the opening set, our opening number for their set. So, first I want to welcome Senior. I'd be remiss. Senior, I know you've been probably having some technical difficulties. welcome to the show. So, we've gotten up to the XA, and I want to show you this bottle, which is really interesting. And it's kind of an interesting function of all of the Don Elias tequilas. You know, it's like a riff on the 1800 shot glass. But then I learned from another blog online and also from their distributor that, like, you're not really supposed to drink what's inside there. It's more of a marketing tool. So it's a little confusing, I must say, because I was thinking, like, well, like, I was trying to, you know, this is what I was really trying to do. Don't laugh at me, but you know me. I was like going, fuck, like, how do I get that extra shot in the bottle? Like, I can't waste that. You know, what the fuck, what's going on? You know, I'm trying to figure out how to get the juice. But I think the short story is, excuse me, there's no way to get that juice in the bottom. It's just a fun thing. Isn't that weird? All right. So, there you go. All right. Now, it's a brown liquid. Hey, who said that? That's what they say. It's a brown liquid. So they said on this, in the chat, Jay Berman. Now, hold on. Jay Berriman. You know, welcome to the show. I don't think you've been here before, and you're a really wonderful presence in the chat tonight. Who are you? How do we know each other? Because I feel like we know each other. Jabere. Well, all right. You know. All right. Dude, send me an email at lippy@tequilawhisperer.com and tell me your whole backstory if I don't already know it. Because we either know each other or we should know each other. All right. Now, Lip, can you finally get to this Don Elias XA? Yes, I can. So here's what I want to tell you about this, people. Interesting brand, as I said, very, very Americanized palate. I want you to taste this when you come to Monterey, and I want you to give me your feedback. So it's got a it's got a big sweetness. It's got a thick plank of super sugar sweet. Gotta tell you. And what happens is when it gets up to the XA, something else starts to intermingle with that sweetness. And the best way I can describe it, and I've described this before, is what I call cologne spice. Okay? So you don't get a lot of that cologne spice on the nose. What you're getting is more of a little bit of an acidity and an acrid on the nose. But when you taste it, Yeah, when you taste it, you get that kind of sweet cologne spice. It's kind of like, if you're a fan of Partida Excelente, what the fuck? Yeah, Excelente, right? Whoa! it feels elegante. It's reminiscent of that elegante. Yeah, thank you. Whew. So, if you're a fan of elegante, and I know a lot of you are, including Senior, you're really going to want to try this Don Elias XA, because they are very similar in that way. There's I've called it on the elegante the same way. I call it that cologne spice. You'll find that the Don Elias is a bit sweeter. So you're going to find, if you're a fan of a sweet tequila, and it's something where, oh my God, you want to turn somebody on, a newbie to tequila, and they've got a very uneducated palate, this is a way to go. Also, and I'm not disdaining it that way, because it might have sounded that way. Also, if you are a fan of sweeter tequilas, now, you know, my palate has been described as rustic, and that was described that way by the beautiful and wonderful Ana Maria Cesena from Casa Dragones. She described my palate as rustic, and I do have a rustic palate. So what does that mean? I'm taking it to mean, you know, I like things that have a lot of kind of vegetal umami, bottom brown, I call it, like a lot of bottom end, a lot of round. Now, you know, I'm not up there on the top. I don't like a lot of highs. I shouldn't say that. I like highs, but I like it in the mix. I really like a lot of bottom brown. Can I say it one more time? You know, bottom brown. And that's the way that goes. All right. And I don't smell any cheese. And all right. So that's where I'm going with this. I'm just checking. Don Elias, I believe Don Elias is available. Hold on. They're in California only right now, but that means that you can still buy them at High Time Wine and any of your favorite California online retailers. Let me cleanse the palate here. I'm going to call my favorite tequila of tonight. These were all medal winners at Monterey, the Monterey Tequila and Mezcal Expo. Do I need to tell you? October 6th, Monterey, California. You should be there. Go online. Crystal in the chat will tell you the exact email address, the internet address. But basically, for all of you people watching in the archive, I want you to search out Monterey Tequila Expo. It will come up, and come see me. I'm going to be everywhere. I'm going to be more places than you want me to be. And you're going to go like, Jesus Christ, Lippy is still hanging around here. Lip! Go eat something, Lip. You know, you keep walking around. We heard that. Is Lip telling that story again? I heard that story, Lip. But, you know, come see me anyway. And bring your party caballito. None of these little ketchup cups. What the fuck is that? No ketchup cups. I'm making a rule. For me, I guess. I don't know. I'm not working for the expo. I don't know what kind of cups they got. All right, let's play a little music here. And, oh, check this out. This is an interesting, well, do you guys want blues, you know, or do you want Ravi Shankar? That could be really cool. So we've got some blues, we've got some Indian music coming up, we've got The Who, right, or Buffalo Springfield. There, I gave you four choices. Buffalo Springfield, The Who, Ravi Shankar, or Canned Heat playing the blues. What do you say, Jay Giles? Shut up. Come on, Jay Giles. All right, so Ravi Shankar, I got to say. It's speaking to me, but, you know, I got another one, Jay Giles. Right. Oh, I got two Ravi Shankar. Come on, and The Who, wait a minute. Oh, yeah. Well, now, all right. Tequila Girl shows up. Woo. All right. You know what? I'm going to play this Ravi Shankar because it's really what I want to hear, too. So I'm glad, you know, for some of you guys, you're going to have to buy the soundtrack to Monterey Pop. For the rest of us, sit back, and you too, sit back and enjoy El Ravi. I think you're going to dig it. It's gone a little soapy. It's opened up, it's gone a little soapy. Just a little bit. Interesting though. Still worth it. Something. That was a while. I feel really high from my virtual joint. Friends, I've been up and down the line of the Monterey Tequila and Mezcal Expo. We haven't even gone to the Mezcals. You know what I'm going to hit the first thing I get there is I'm going to hit all the Mezcals because I've tasted all. Do you know how many brands are going to be there? I think it's going to be like 60 some different ages of tequila, 70. But I'm going to hit the mezcal first, I think. Just to fuck up the tasties. Just because I'm that kind of guy. Because the tasties are going to go... And even senior. Senior, what are you going for first? Front row? I know these guys are going. I know we're all going to be caravanning down in a car. Look. I went up and down the line. The lip has a call. Although this isn't exactly appropriate because nobody asked me to pick my favorite. But, you know, I will always tell you how I really feel. That's our unspoken agreement. It's our bond. You know what I would drink right now? Show shuts down. These are the only tequilas I have in the house. And you're all here with me. Everybody raises their glass. What do you all say? What do you think it's going to be? You start knocking on the door and then you start putting the glass. Come on, Lip. Come on, Lip. You know, pour for me. Pour for me. It's my turn. It's my turn. Well, I do have a tequila while all of them have their own highlights and their own specific I'm just looking at the chat. Everybody's got their own and these are worthy brands for all the reasons that I talked about earlier. But if the Lip has to make a call, what will it be? Which one would I pick up and start pouring into your and pouring ample tastes into your ample bosom glasses? Yes, Alderete, you son of a gun. I'm going to pop that cork. Look, I'm going to need another couple of bottles. Yeah, you Bailey. Yes, yes, yes. I got to tell you something. As worthy as these other brands are, there is something about Alderete Añejo in particular. It speaks to the Lip. It does make me excited. And it does make me want more. It is that way. Now, that's the way it worked out. And I'm glad it worked out that way because I really like it. All right. I want to thank all the other brands for sending me their samples. Don Elias, Mi Casa, Azul Imperial. Excuse me. Really great stuff that I want you to taste at the Monterey Tequila Expo. I want you to taste that Blanco. I want you to taste that Repo. Actually, I know you're going to taste all ages of these brands. And then I want you to taste Don Elias. Tell me what you think of them all. Give me your feedback. You can argue with me on the show floor. Crystal will be there to break up any fights. Now, I don't want you to go anywhere because we're going to do a quickie after show where I'm going to draw the lucky winner among many of you. Thank you who have signed my petition. We'll talk about that in the after show. But I want to say thank you to all the brands who are going to be at the Monterey Tequila and Mezcal Expo, October 6th, Saturday. Get your tickets, people. We're all going to be there. It's Northern California's... It's like the Miss Mexico America of tequila. Can I say that? All right. Am I missing anything in the chat? How did I miss that petition? Yeah, that's right, you some bitch. I believe me, I checked off everybody who signed it. And when you didn't sign it, you went on my shit list, buddy boy. For sure. All right. It was on Facebook. I'm just reading this. You guys are so great. Thank you so much. Now, hold on. I gotta do a little business here. Thank you for coming. Stick around. I'm going to be back in about 1.5 minutes, God willing. I told you about my tech trouble. But Monterey coming up, the Lip, you know, I cut back to my show. Just feels good to be here. Feels good to be with you. When's the next one? Well, why don't we do one pretty quick, pretty soon? Why don't we do one right after Monterey? I got a lot of brands here. People keep sending me tequila. I am up to my, I was going to say my ass. I'm up to my nipples in tequila. You know what I think I'm going to do? I think I'm going to load up my car so high with tequila. And I'm going to be, nah, maybe I'm not. Good night, everyone. Thank you for coming. I want to see you next weekend. Get there. Hey, now, come on.